Shalom, shalom everybody. This is Ronny Simon. I would like to say a few words today to give an update about what is the situation with Corona in Israel. We are part of the world after all, and we did have a nice success with the first wave. And we have everything was done according to what it was supposed to be done. There was a lockdown, quarantines, people very responsible. We had some amazing demonstrations of solidarity. People helped one another. Everybody was recruited for the job. And it looked like it was a success. But then, very carelessly, the government decided to open everything almost overnight and almost go back to normal. And that was the beginning of a disaster. Now, we knew that it may happen, and the hope was that we had 3 months or so to prepare for the second wave. Looks like almost nothing was done. So now we are labeled as a red country, basically, and we have close to 2,000 cases diagnosed every day. Again, not that many are in a severe condition. The death toll is not that bad. I know it's something not very nice to say because every life matters. The thing is that when you take that per population, it's one of the lowest in the world, but the infection rate is definitely high. And therefore, when Europe is going back to normal, give or take, with some problems there as well, but the skies are open, the borders are open, people can travel. Israel is still labeled as a red country, which means that in most European countries we cannot go to. Now, many people can come to Israel. If you're an Israeli civilian, you have the right to come back home. But Israel only accepts, as per now, Israeli civilians. For example, we are celebrating the Jewish New Year in about a month to about a month and a half. And always for New Year's, a lot of people come to visit, especially ultra-Orthodox people from the US of A. And they want to bring those people this year as well. We talk about tens of thousands of people, and you do understand the problem. This is not the time for that. Definitely not in this condition. But if the government decides not to take them in, it will lead to a major crisis. You may lose the government because the ultra-Orthodox parties are very strong in the coalition. And unless it's done their way, they will not support the government. So if you want to keep political stability, you have to jeopardize some of the health issues in the country. We'll see how that will help. Maybe some public pressure will help. And there was a lot of demonstration going on around the country as we speak. Demonstrators are coming from different parts of society with different agendas, but it looks like it's picking up. Every weekend, the Sabbath is our only day of rest, but Sabbath evening after the Sabbath is over, the bridges over the highways in the country are filled with hundreds of people on every bridge. This whole movement is called the Black Flag Movement, and they protest against basically corruption in the government. They protest against the prime minister himself, not just the corruption and not just the legal issues that he has, but also they protest against the incompetence that the government is demonstrating, unfortunately, for quite a while, to try to stabilize the economy. So people that lost their jobs will join in the protests as well. So we have lots of people coming from different reasons to protest, but this is a wave that cannot be ignored anymore. Every weekend, Sabbath evening, the biggest demonstration takes place outside the Prime Minister's house in Jerusalem. And every week we speak about thousands of people. The police is very nervous. It's, of course, quite a problem for the neighbors who live in the area. It doesn't affect yet, at least, the government, so to speak. But it's a momentum that started, and we'll see how it's going to evolve. Israel is not very good in protesting to try to get more civil liberties or protesting against almost other issues. Very seldom will do that. When it comes to government corruption, when it comes now to the finances and the economy, which is in a terrible condition, and it looks like there's total confusion. Finally, after almost half a year of struggling with that, the government was appointing a projector, somebody who is responsible, maybe he's going to run the whole project of the corona pandemic in Israel. He's going to have full authority, and he's going to coordinate all the branches of government, including the army, to fight it effectively. And only 3 days later, some cabinet ministers question his capabilities and his integrity. It's absolutely crazy. So the government is not working well enough. It doesn't look like anybody knows exactly what's going on. The information that we get is so confusing. the Board of Health, they hold all the data and they're cut so close to the chest that nobody has access to the data. So it's hard to tell based on what they make decisions. They decided to quarantine a certain town, a certain city, a certain beach, and nobody gives it reasons why, and nobody knows what's going on. So transparency is something that this government is not very good at, and that brings a lot of resentment from the people. It looks like over the last few days that we came to the climax of the second round, and maybe it starts a decline. So on one hand side, since we do a lot of tests, we do have a lot of people proven to carry the virus. On the other hand, the hospitals are not really packed. We only have about less than 100 people that have to be ventilated and using ventilators. Very few are in a critical condition. And from the beginning of it, we lost more than 500 people for the coronavirus. I think that we lost more people for other conditions over the last half year anyhow. So again, since you don't have this transparency and you don't have government agencies to be simply honest with the people to explain why they make those decisions, it's hard to get people's cooperation. At the same time, the government, to try to deal with the financial problem, is simply throwing money at people in a way that we do not understand. They made the decision, for example, 3 weeks ago, that everybody in the country, everybody, is going to get some money. Well, the amounts are not that big, 750 shekels per person, which is about $220. And then if you have children, every child will get 500 shekels. And if you have more than four, so the fifth one will get about 200 shekels. So sometimes it accumulates to thousands for a family that doesn't need it. So they did not even differentiate to say, listen, we have enough data to know who needs that allowance, if you wish, or that donation, or that whatever, money, and who doesn't. And they said, if you want to make it fast and you don't want to be too picky and too specific, we have to give that to everybody. Well, most people don't need the money. Some people are desperately need the money. So why not take another day or two and have the right data from Social Security? They have the information. And then you can decide to take the same amount of money that you wanted to spend anyhow and give it to people that really need that. Now, the answer was, well, we want to do it fast because you always complain that it doesn't happen fast enough. If you want to do it fast, everybody is going to get some money. Well, it looks like we are not thinking in a rational way. The unity government that was born only for one reason, to fight corona, is not really functioning. They have a committee made of 10 cabinet members. They're not making any progress. They argue all the time about all kinds of political issues. They don't seem to care much about what happened with the pandemic, and we have to pass a budget soon, and there's no budget by August 25th. The government has to basically resign. So it looks like nobody cares about the things which are really important, and nobody is recruiting all the effort that the nation has. Because Israel knows tension. Israel knows emergency situations. We're all prepared for that. What stops it from playing a full role is politics. And this is a mind-blowing situation. So, again, you can sense some of my frustration when I try to share that with you. But it is the most important issue that we have on the table. Because if we're not going back to a full capacity financially, if tourism is devastated, if no public events are taking place, we are never going to be recovered. So now if we are successful to drop down the cases that we have in the country, and maybe our category will be orange and then maybe will be green, which means that's how countries are categorized, we can open the skies and people can start come to visit, and maybe tourism will be restored as well. So yes, you heard some bitterness in my voice when I tried to share that with you. Maybe you have the same feelings and the same sentiments back home, but it's just the way that governments function, most likely. It doesn't have to be like that. You have some European examples which are much, much better, but not here in Israel. It's all about politics. And only time will tell how we're going to reconcile politics with health issues, because by now it takes a terrible toll from the economy. Not everybody is part of it. Some people getting their allowances, getting the budgets and the money as if nothing happened. And these people are making zero contribution to the state. Yes, I'm speaking about the ultra-Orthodox yeshiva students that they don't work, basically. They get a certain budget from the country. Now, their condition did not worsen in any way. They still get the same. So why do they have to be rewarded by having additional money than other people that have businesses that collapse need much more? Well, I have to leave that as a question that I cannot answer. Well, thank you all for watching and joining me, and may the God of Israel richly bless you all.